There's one authentication question I'm going to ask you. There's one authentication question I'm going to ask you because it's one that relates intimately to both of us. Because this is Kenneth Clark's book.
Yep.
And you wrote the wonderful introduction. I was telling people about it before. And look what's on the inside.
Yeah. I couldn't get rid of it.
Right. So I don't feel so bad. I don't feel so bad that it's also on the cover of my book. Even though the last time we talked, you explained to me, no. And we changed in the introduction to our online program, we changed to the profile, which we think was done by Meltzer, right?
Yeah, that is normally attributed to him, but it's by somebody very close to him who got the Leonardo style, though isn't Leonardo himself.
Would you just share with everybody how you determined that the image that everyone uses as the go-to portrait of Leonardo as an old man, how we know that it isn't actually what it's set up to be?
Yeah. The most reliable portrait is the one at Windsor, which, as you say, is attributed often to Francesco Meltzer, the most educated dedicated of Leonardo's companions, followers, and the kind of amanuensis who looked after things at his death. It may be by him. It's a reasonable attribution. And that face, which is very beautiful, Leonardo was described as very beautiful, very handsome. That is consistent with other early portraits. None of the early portraits are done directly from Leonardo, but they come from a tradition. So there's a series of images, both profile and three-quarter face, all of which have this rather refined head. No, rather refined nose, thin but refined lips, very regular eyes. And that persists, and that goes all the way through to the late 18th century. Then Giuseppe Bossi in Milan publicized drawing in Turin, which is just down the road from Milan, and wanted that to be the self-portrait. And it fits with our idea of a genius in a way, this very eccentric, long-haired, grumpy-looking individual who is sort of glowering with deep thoughts about the nature of the world and humanity and so on. So it in a sense fits with our idea of a genius and almost a Beethovenian figure in a way. But it's a late 18th century invention. It then got established, and I can't really shift it. I've done my best to lever it out of the way, and it's even the Italians and even Turin are saying it is now described as a portrait of Leonardo rather than certifying it. But the drawing at Windsor, which is very, very nice drawing and shows this immensely poised, very beautiful, handsome man with cascades of wavy hair, and corresponds with the literary descriptions of Leonardo.
Lovely. Thank you so much, Martin. So.